Hi everyone! Narito po tayo ngayon sa pamantasan ng lungsod ng Valenzuela at ngayon po ay masasakitsehan natin ang kahalagahan ng technology sa edukasyon. Tara! Yes.
Yes, at some point.
Yes.
Yes.
I would say yes.
Number one benefit. When students are engaged in technology, they are proven to be more interested in the topic they are studying. In fact, technology provides an avenue to make the topics easier and more interesting to their students. For an instance, delivering teaching activities through gamification and also virtual trips. What is more is, technology can encourage a more active participation in the learning process, which can be hard to achieve through a traditional learning environment.
Dani, tignan mo nga ito. Ayan kasi magde-demo ako. Tignan mo ba makukuha ko yung attention dyan? Kasi ganito yan, kunwari pipili sila ng ng word. Tapos, example ito, pag pinindot, ganyan, ayan din. May points din, ganyan.
So, pipili lang sila ng word and then?
Oh, pwede na lang gamitin sa sentence.
Okay yan, kasi mas magiging exciting yan for the students. Hindi sila mag-board, alam mo yun. Kasi kapag hindi siya colorful or ka-creative, hindi maaani yung attention ng mga bata.
Saka naisip ko kasi games eh.
Oo.
Naisip ko sa games.
Alam mo naman yung mga bata ngayon.
Studying in the topic they are interested in engaged are expected to have a better knowledge retention. As mentioned before, technology can help the learning process when teachers are engaging their students and they are immersing their students with technology. With that, we are fully accomplishing the knowledge retention of the students, which is important in the learning process.
Uy, nakapag-review ka na ba? Para sa quiz natin next week?
Oo, nag-review na nga ako actually. Diba dito yung nakalagay yung yung slide ni Mama about sa sa projectors.
Ayan dito. Tapos, sa kapilang slide kasi noon, tanda ko, yung
taxonomy
pa. Oo, dito yun. Tapos may ganun pa dito yan. Oo, ganyan. Basta natandaan ko kasi kapag nakikita ko talaga, buti nga may projector ka.
But what better way of coping the students' different paces and different learning strategy?
Technology would be the answer for that. Technology would greatly open different opportunities in order to cope up with the different learning styles and learning strategies that learner may possess.
For example, the internet access provides the students a wide range of resources to conduct different studies or researches.
Join course kayo. Tapos ayan, sasagutan nyo. Oo, may papanoorin kayong mga lessons niya. Sagot-sagot na after nun. Sipin nyo, di ba? Parang ang saya at ang okay. Kasi nasa bahay ka lang, may matutunan ka na. And
ayan,
at the same time.
Preposition.
Ayan, start quiz. Tapos Emmy, lalabas sabihin yung tanong. So, which verb is not used with about?
So, approve?
Contain, approve. Sige, try natin. Okay, pumaklik. Check answer.
That was number 3. How about our number 4? Technology promotes skillful collaboration with other students. For example, it promotes a collaboration with online activities in which every student can participate even though they are not present or distant in their meeting. For instance, working on different projects by collaborating with others on forums or sharing video files and documents in online avenue. With that, this only proves that technology encourages students to collaborate with their classmates or with their schoolmates or with around the world.
Ano ba? Natapos mo na? Send mo na lang dito. Send mo na sa GC. Send mo na lang ha.
Sige.
Teachers and students can develop essential skills that are necessary in the 21st century. With that, we can conclude that modern learning is about collaborating with others, solving complex problems, critical thinking, developing different forms of communication, and leadership skills, which necessitate the presence of technology. As what I said a while ago, the practical skills that a learner may develop, creating PowerPoint presentations and determining which among the sources are considered as reliable and unreliable.
Ano ba naman ito? Ang daming pinapagawa niya.
Hindi ako marunong kumuha ng PowerPoint eh.
Girl, kailangan matulog?
Buti. Hindi ko kasi alam kung saan ko ng PowerPoint na, alam mo yun, maganda, tapos interesting.
Guys, sa trabaho natin sa future, kailangan ma-master natin yung paggawa ng PowerPoint. Ganda lang yan, girls.
Sige nga, ito
nga. Pwede ka akong gumamit ng WPS or Microsoft. Ganito, girl.
Sige nga. Training.
Ayan. Okay. So, WPS yung gamit natin. May nakalagay dito, sige. Yung layout, reset, set. Yung layout, ayan. May mga pagpipilian ka dyan. Depende sa gagawin mo. Laman nung yung PowerPoint. Ayun girl, ganito. May naka-ready na ako PowerPoint. So, tapos na siya.
Wow! Ang galing si Sophie. Thank you so much. Sulit ka na marami.
At yan. Dito, dinefine yung technology. Anong gamit niya? Anong sense?
Ay, girl! Wikipedia? Ganto. Share ko sa'yo yung pinagkuhaan ko ng reference. Tinuro sa amin to ng teacher namin na mahilig mo sabi ng go-go!
Oh, sige!
Ito, squeaky journals. Ayan. Ito, legit to girl.
Squeaky journals.
Tapos dito mo nanghanapin yung kailangan mong mga topic.
Hello, thank you.
Resources, technology can help improve teaching. Teachers can use different apps or trusted online resources to enhance the traditional ways of teaching and to keep students more engaged. Virtual lesson plans, grading software, and online assessments can help teachers save a lot of time. This valuable time can be used for working with students who are struggling. What is more, having virtual learning environment in schools enhances collaboration and knowledge sharing between teachers. The kids with the pumped up kids.